Welcome back to Upfront. We are talking about corrections reform in Wisconsin with state representatives Evan Goyke of Milwaukee and Michael Schrah of Oshkosh, Democrat and Republican. Representative Goyke, the Democrat, in this discussion. Let's talk a little bit about Lincoln Hills, juvenile offenders. There was an agreement that said Lincoln Hills would close by 2021. Is that still possible?
2021, yes. The complexity of the change in which the Act 185 that passed last session may need a little bit more time. We're hearing from the local players, counties, that are going to be responsible for the care of more youth under this new system. What we're doing is decentralizing juvenile corrections. Instead of one big institution, we'll have smaller, more regional facilities that'll keep kids closer to their homes. And that's a good goal, but it's very complicated. And so what I think folks should expect in the first couple months of this legislative session is some clarifying language on a couple of points. This was legislation that Representative Schrah and I and others worked on in the last moments of the legislative session. So we need to clarify a few things, and that timeline looks like on the local level, we're going to need a little bit more time. But I don't think we're going to delay this years. More a matter of months.
Is there enough money to make this transition to more local facilities?
From the study committee that we sat on, I think we're getting the indication that more funding is going to be needed. We didn't have a lot of time to put this together, and the timelines, we did the best that we could with the time that we had. So I think, as Representative Goyke talked about, you know, extending the closure date, we want to do it right. And I think in order to do that, we're probably going to have to look at a little bit of additional funding from the models that have come in from architects and some of the preliminary bids. I think that we're going to have to put more money into it to do it the right way.
Governor-elect Evers has said he will visit Lincoln Hills in the first week after being sworn into office. You encouraged by that?
I think it's a great sign that, I want to give a lot of credit to Lieutenant Governor Barnes, who worked on this issue when he was in the Assembly. He and I went up almost 4 years ago now. Governor Evers was on our study committee this summer, attended the meetings, was engaged, and this was while he was running for governor. And those experiences, plus his commitment to go up and talk to staff and youth there, I think it shows a promise and a commitment to work with us to make sure the system works right.
Final question for Representative Schrah, something we have not talked about, but there's another side to this, and that is the people who work in corrections facilities.
Right.
Do we have to address that?
We have, in my opinion, we're at crisis levels, Mike. In the next 3 to 5 years, we could have up to 40% of the existing correctional officers retire. We're having a problem with retention. And I think one of the ways to solve that, we have a great economy, and that's one of the issues. We have to increase the starting wage. I think the starting wage is $16.30 an hour. I think we've got to be in the $18 an hour area to compete with corporate business. And then we need some incentives to retain the individuals that have been there 10, 15, 20 years. Before we look at overcrowding, before we look at some of the other issues, we need to make sure that the individuals that are protecting the public are taken care of.
Representative Schrah and Representative Goyke, thanks very much for being with us today. We appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mike.
Outgoing Republican Governor Scott Walker isn't ruling out another run for public office. In a final round of interviews with Wisconsin media on Friday, Walker said a run for U.S. Senate or even a 2022 run for governor isn't out of the question.
What about running for governor again? Is that in the cards at all?
I don't rule anything out, but I think realistically it's probably in 4 years' time for Republicans to give somebody else a new chance, a new face.
Next, the water in Wisconsin. Why in some places you wouldn't want to drink it.